Naturally, perhaps it will spread in a more systematic way. So it is really sad that service users, they are left to only professional treatment and other avenues which are available at the community level and which are equally important. In fact, the finishing touches can be given only by this community community type of interventions. Person can recover significantly through may significantly recover through medication and counseling, but the kind of life that he wants, he can get it only through support group and other kind of similar important things. My view about stigma reduction is that one did not insist on other people to speak on a public forum, because this was an issue in our group also, that some people used to think that if you are benefiting by the organization, you should speak publicly. But I always thought that people should be given choice. If they want to speak, if they are recovered enough, if they are convinced enough, if they are able to cope up with the pressures when they expose themselves to the other people, then only they should speak on the public platform. So I think that this should be kept open. And we have started with a new initiative, which we call as a Stitch Initiative, Stitch 50K. And this initiative is basically to address public stigma. Means we want people to change their language, words, the way they behave. We want them to change. So this is the initiative. And as a part of initiative, we are collecting experiences of service users, and some 250, 300 experiences we have already collected. And our target is to collect 500 experiences. So collecting 500 experiences will help us to understand how people, what is the impact of stigma, what are the different shades of stigma, and how different people take stigma in a different way. So this is our initiative. And part of this initiative, motivating more service users to speak in front of public audience, in front of public, that is also one of our objectives. And a couple of individuals have become ready, and in our public programs, they also share their stories. And we all know that the direct contact, that is a service user talking in front of, that is more effective as compared to any other public education programs. So we are also including that component also. And this is our views about support group and stigma. And let me know if you have any question or any comment, any addition. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Anilji.
Thank you.
This was very helpful presentation. Thank you so much for sharing your personal experiences.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm sure, you know, many of us can connect with what you said.
I will be happy.
So are there any? So if anyone wants to say anything in response to Anilji's presentation or want to share your own experience, connect with what he said.
Monaji and Anilji, I resonate a lot with what you shared, that initiating that movement of the peer support helped you also in immensely, right, Anilji? That was my experience entirely also. we correct, began correct. Our offline peer support meets 5 years ago. We've been meeting every month since then. And that has helped me evolve as a person, understand mental health at a deeper level, understand human behavior, help co-create a model of resilience, I can say.
That's
because
true.
Most of the pain points are, there is some overlap, I would say, right?
That's true.
Yeah. And of course, you talked about the stigma and discrimination. There have been people who have shared in our groups and in our meetings, they have shared some secrets and their inner emotions and experiences with their closest family members are not aware of, you know. So that is the kind of bonding and trust which a support group can develop. And although that might sharing might not happen in public, it helps really act as a release, I feel, isn't it? Yeah. So that I agree with a lot of what you said. Connected a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks, Vijayji.
Yeah.
Vijayji, you also run support groups as part of Bipolar India.
Yes, that's right. Although Bipolar India was initiated in 2013, our peer support movement began in 2015 in Mumbai. Mm-hmm. And the same issue we are also facing, which Anilji is talking about, that we have tried to start the peer movement elsewhere also. For instance, in Delhi, Bengaluru, but I mean for some for it to have that level of consistency, it needs a lot of commitment, from the people there who are in charge locally. So that is an observation. Another observation which I can agree with in totality. Yeah. So it's easier to start a movement, but more difficult to sustain it and to ensure that it gathers steam anywhere.
I agree with you, Vijayji. I agree, completely agree with you. And we also need people or organizations that can work together for it to expand to other parts.
And meanwhile, in this during this pandemic, we have conducted 21 meets or webinars online, so to keep the momentum going. Last Sunday was the latest one that we had.
Okay, so do share if you any such groups with everyone on the group, Vijayji.
Sure, definitely. On the WhatsApp group itself, our group, I can share some details.
Yes, please do share such information about such groups for those people who want to join.
Definitely.
Can I say something, please?
Yes, Pooja.
Yeah, in Delhi, the Bohr Foundation runs Bohr Foundation Listening Circles. Though we are not centered, I've been a part of that group for long now and sometimes mentored the group also. So we do not address a specific mental health issue like Bipolar India, but it is like across the board. My specific experience with those peer support meetings has been that so many times it is not even a mental health issue, women have come up to us with a domestic violence issue. Sometimes youngsters have come up with an abuse issue. So that way, peer support groups also have a huge social role to play, creating safe spaces for any kind of marginalization or oppression. People feel listened to. People feel that they will get the proper guidance and they will not be misguided, or their experience will not be just negated or, brushed under the carpet, so to say. So that has been very good, but I would agree with Vijayji that to sustain it, like earlier before the pandemic, we were having physical meetings in Delhi and sometimes even district-wise meetings. Like in East, we would have a meeting and in South, we would have another meeting. But then, after the pandemic also, the meetings have been going online. But of course, when you're dealing with something as sensitive as mental health or trauma, I believe it is so important. The medium is so important. So some people are not very comfortable with videos or with online medium. The meetings have been going on for the past 5-6 weeks. I have not been able to do it because of my other professional commitment. But that is one very reliable support group that is active in Delhi, and I can share details if anybody in Delhi wants to join it.
Thanks. Thank you so much. I think this kind of information we should keep sharing with each other.
Referring to what Pooja was saying, although we started with focus exclusively on bipolar disorder, now our meets are not restricted to that at all. All right. So it could be somebody with any mental health issue. Now we have several people with major depressive disorders, a couple of people with OCD, some with just anxiety disorder. It could be a range of issues that people come up with, and as well as, of course, the caregiver community, the families of these people. So it's a vast ecosystem that now we are addressing. All right.
That's great because my two areas have disability and mental health, and a lot of people have connected across the board. I have had parents who have a child with a disability, but that was affecting their relationship and their mental health because managing the child. So the child had a physical disability. So on and so forth. There are so many intersections also in mental health. And we are all trying to, make it as much as intersectional and diverse as we can.
Yeah.
I think... that is good what Vijayji, you have shared, that apart from bipolar patients, you also now allow other patients also. Because in India, the awareness about self-help group is limited. So we cannot have groups only for bipolar or people with schizophrenia or people with depression. In Western countries where there is a large number of people do attend groups. That is okay. But in our country, it is not, means we have to once have one single group at this stage. But only thing I would like to say that we cannot combine all the issues. Means, for example, if there are people with MR, or there are old people having some geriatric problem or dementia problem, because then there cannot be a focused discussion. If you include people with any issue, means as somebody said, domestic violence or something, then the discussion cannot be focused. And so that is my view. And secondly, I would also like to ask Vijayji, right now, are you having combined group of caregivers and service users?
At the moment, yes. See, the issue that we have faced, Anilji, is sometimes, the people being in denial. All right. Yeah. So I agree that with what you were saying, that there is sometimes there is a clash of interest when we are addressing these two sections. Right. Yeah. Right. But in our case, what happens? Sometimes the caregivers won't come until the person who is affected pushes them to attend a meeting or some, and the vice versa also. All right. Now, so suppose if you say only family members are supposed to attend a meet, their child or the spouse might not will be willing to come individually, So that level of commitment to attend these meets is still not developed. Yeah. But in the long run, we are focusing on exclusive caregiver community also. Yes, so that is important.
I'd like to add something to this.
Can I respond to Anilji about this diversity of issues first? And then please, sure. Just a minute.
Okay, yeah, Pooja.
What I'm trying to say is that, yes, of course, there needs to be specific focus on mental health in mental health groups. I cited that example to say that there's a lack of safe spaces for all kind of marginalized people. The lady with a domestic violence issue could not go seeking help to a women's NGO. So she came to us. She didn't know what to do. And we told her that you do not have a mental health. It doesn't look like a mental health issue. It's a domestic violence issue. So you should get probably this kind of specific help. And she was guided further to take specific kind of help, legally and otherwise, for her issue. But I don't think that there is any harm in being a first aid kind of support or a peer support or the base of the pyramid, so to say, where conversations are open, because mental health is not isolated. A lot of it also comes because of trauma. A lot of it happens also because of all kinds of trauma. There are children who feel that something is wrong with them, and they have probably a stammering issue. But they later on, when they open up and they come up with the issue that they have been dealing with trauma of abuse. So that is what I'm trying to say, that of course, they won't stay forever in the same group, and then diverse groups will not have focused discussions. But what I was trying to say is the safety of these spaces and the inclusivity of these spaces is what makes them so open to people, to all kinds of people facing some discrimination. Yeah.
Thank you, Pooja. I actually wanted to just add, in our peer support group as well, we've had instances of people talking about drug abuse. We've had instances of people talking about domestic violence at home, maybe not directed towards them, but their parents. And at some point, we have to address these issues because their mental health gets impacted by these things. So we have to address domestic violence. We have to address drug abuse. We have to address all kinds of issues that affect people's mental health. And which is why I think it's important that we build our understanding about these things as well to be able to provide mental health first aid. Otherwise, just to say that I have a bipolar disorder, somebody else has a borderline personality disorder, and we're just giving support for that, it really doesn't cover the whole thing, because our reactions are to situations, and those situations don't just go away. So we have to discuss these things and make them a part of our every day schedule at peer support groups.
I think Pooja and Hena, you have brought up this very important topic about, you know, and we've been discussing of intersectionality of mental health with other issues. And, you know, what is important here is to remember the capacity of the group. So suppose a few people who are experiencing schizophrenia or bipolar who have started this group may not have a capacity to be able to deal with issues like domestic violence or gender issues. That is why the peer support networks, we need to have a formal system. They need to be formalized. We need to have training sessions on how to facilitate these peer support groups. I think that is what Anilji also brought up, that we need to start thinking of it as a tier in the treatment system. I mean, it's an important part of treatment system. It should not be just like, you know, when people coming together, like, you know, they're sitting outside OPD and talking to each other. It should not be that. It should be, there should be goals of such groups. There should be training. They should be facilitated. And of course, Anilji, you want to say anything in response to what Hena and Pooja just mentioned? Anilji?
I think what they have shared is very important, there are some conflict of goals. If you make it too broad, then whatever we have to achieve through the self-help group, there are difficulties. And organize my thoughts. Let me organize.
So can I take Karthik's question till then, if you...
One thing, something different I would like to say, perhaps Vijayji. When we started a self-help group for service users, we did not have any idea about what to do exactly. And we thought that sharing is the important. And we have initial experience of sharing and we realize that by sharing, all problems are solved. Since everything is because that is the only thing. But over time, we gradually realize that sharing is one step. It is not all. Because in sharing, it started happening in our group that people started sharing their complaints. And then it became actually a complaint group. People started sharing, no doubt. But then it became a complaint group, how my family members or boss, and how they don't understand, et cetera, et cetera. And we realized that this is not the group that will help the service users, because a group should help them to take steps in their recovery. And that is why we were looking for some method which is simple to understand, simple to practice, simple to remember, and at the same time effective. And that is how we came across one recovery method, and which is actually developed quite long time back, almost 80 to 90 years ago. But it is based on cognitive behavioral therapy, CBT. It is a very simple method. For example, in the method, some tools are used, what they call as tools. And people recall the tools when they have distressing incidences or situations. Maintaining my internal peace is my supreme goal. This is one of the tools. People don't irritate me, I get irritated. People don't irritate me, I get irritated. I cannot control external environment, I can control internal environment. So such kind of tools are used, and everyone who is interested can share his experience with the help of these tools, the incidences and tools. So it happened that some people thought that this method is also restricting their freedom. So whatever you do, it happens that if you follow some rules, or if you have a structured meeting, some people may not like it. But then you have to consider what the majority will like to do, will like to follow. And that is how we are using this recovery method in our self-help group.
Anilji, in fact, this very Sunday last meet, I did a presentation on CBT. Yeah. So I think the lockdown gave us an opportunity to have structured meetings, you know, because otherwise, especially in online, everybody speaks at the same time. It is difficult to control the flow of the conversation. So we shifted to a structured flow for the meets, you know, have a specific topic, all right, where 1.5 hour, 90 minutes presentation or a, you know, specific demonstration, and then have a free flow of conversations. Yeah. So what we have done is, you know, we had 3 sessions of art therapy. We had 2 sessions on yoga and pranayam, especially for mental health. One session by a gold medalist nutritionist, you know, so, and 3 sessions by psychologist. So we are headed in the similar direction which you are referring to, you know, so it gives us sense of purpose, direction, and essentially what you talk about, the goal should be recovery, sustainable recovery, right? I mean, how can we facilitate that, you know, make it easier through this holistic environment?
Yeah. May I share something, please?
Yes, please, yes. Please.
So how we do it is basically we talk about these things in order to understand our triggers. So if we know that domestic violence at home is triggering us, we are able to then make suggestions or observations accordingly. So the idea is not just to complain. The idea is to actually understand our own triggers and how we can in a way strategize to avoid those triggers or accept those triggers in a way to avoid them. The idea is that, but unless we understand why these things are triggering us, or why they affect us in the way they do, we need to be able to talk about them and address them. So that is exactly how I have kind of structured our peer support model.
I agree with you, Hina. Actually, how will the support group will develop? It all depends from place to place. The kind of people that have come together, the way facilitator is facilitating the group. So everything depends upon the composition of the group. So it happened in Pune. That may not necessarily happen in other parts, but it happened in Pune. So we started thinking. But you have rightly pointed out that some different course also can follow if the instructions are given accordingly.
Hina, I agree with a lot with what you said, the connect there, that rather than brushing aside the issues that people face day in, day out in their lives, especially the women in our group, all right? Making them understand the circumstance, environment, the toxic environment, which we know is a trigger for them. All right. Yeah. A solution cannot arise without addressing that trigger, I believe. I agree totally with that. So how can they develop coping mechanisms? That is what then we try to address. So then Anilji, I would say that we shouldn't look that these things are complaints, but these are the real issues that people face, and because they feel that they can open up without holding back in our community, meets, they do so, right? If you look at these issues constructively, and with compassion.
There is one question.
I think there's a question from Karthik.
He wants to ask that, how can we mobilize people in the cities? And Gauri also supports the question. And in Pune,
I think in smaller cities, it may be easier to do so in Delhi, Mumbai, or Pune. What about smaller cities or districts? I think that's what Karthik wants to know.
Actually, as Karthik and Gauri also have rightly pointed out, the stigma is much more in smaller cities, and for example, in case of Maharashtra, what we have found, general experience, in Mumbai, Pune, Nasik, these are the developed cities. And in these cities, we have found that that way people are ready to come. If we organize a meeting, people are, they do respond. But some places like Kolhapur, Kolhapur and other districts, many districts of Maharashtra, which are supposed to be socially backward also, and which do not have any, socially backward also. So there we found that mobilizing people is not easy. And we have to keep on trying. I think that is the only way. We have to take help of local psychiatrist body. In Nagpur, in Nashik, we are in touch with psychiatrist bodies. And not only that, some of the bodies, they really support our initiative. They put up posters in their respective members' clinics. So in Nashik, there are 36 members, posters that such group is being organized, vagare vagare. So I think that you have to keep on trying. Articles in the newspapers, and now the social media is important. So I think that if people realize that there are benefits of coming into the open, and the risk of disclosure is minimum, because people always, I think, there is a tendency cost-benefit analysis, something like that. What I gain by getting exposed, and what I will lose. So when people realize And we really think that now the society, the present society, is in that situation that the cost, social cost of getting exposed is less and the benefits are more. So we have to keep on trying and we have to improve our skills, public speaking skills or writing skills. I think that is what we have to. Karthik, you have any question?
Nothing, sir. That's it. How many psychiatrists are really welcome when you go to rural areas like Kolhapur and Cholapur? Did they really encourage you to start a support group?
Some of, you see, at all places, welcome. In Nashik, in Pune, in some other places, response is quite good, but not at all places. As you said, in Kolhapur, we haven't received. And then you have to push in your own way. So I think that we have to try in a variety of ways. I always feel that in Maharashtra, stigma is much more, we say. But then if we could mobilize some 50, 20 people, or let's say 50 people, like Vijayji is there, myself is there, some other people are there, and who are ready to speak openly and who are doing good in their career also. I think the stigma will melt quite fast. Stigma is there, no doubt. And psychiatrists are not cooperating. That is also true. But then we have to develop some innovative ways also. Because we cannot simply keep on trying at one point only. And whenever they change their mind, then only we can go ahead. We have to keep open some innovative ways also.
Anilji, here I would like to add something.
Yes, know, please.
This is the insight I have learned.
Please, yeah.
Some psychiatrists are resistant in referring people to a community because of insecurity, professional insecurity.
Because of?
Professional insecurity. So now that is also a barrier. So what happens is, what if we recommend them to some other psychiatrist? You know, all right. So we have noticed this happening. But as you pointed out, do we also need psychiatrists for any all of these meets? You know, it's not really necessary. In our meets, you know, in the 5-year meets, no professional has attended any of these meets. Only when we have specific conferences or, you know, online sessions do we have the professionals addressing us, you know, right? So they can be conducted without even intervention by mental health professionals, Karthik, I would say, you know, to begin with at least, you know, because then once the movement gathers strength, now it is the other way around. There are people flooding us with offers of aligning with Bipolar India, you know, because now they find that there is a, you know, community that they can tap. Professionals want to join hands with Bipolar India. And now we are using a filter to see what are their intentions. Yeah. So if we start even without the support of psychiatrists on our own, a few people who are committed to the cause, who have experiences to share a little bit of awareness about mental health issues. Don't you think, Anilji, that also can be a method to start with, you know, in the beginning? Yeah.
Yeah.
Without a psychiatrist supporting us.
Yeah, definitely. We can start with that. And I think the, let's say in the future, if we can jointly conduct some conference only on support group. We also brought out one small booklet on how to conduct support group meetings. So like that, if we create some literature and also organize a conference where we can invite the representatives from other places. You see, if we have sufficient number, then we will get the strength also. If we are at 10 places, district places, suppose there are support groups, then we will get strength. And each one of the group will be respected, will be accept that this can be one of the supporting way of way.
Is this a booklet available online or something, Anilji?
No, we haven't. It is in Marathi, basically, actually. I can send it to you.
But it is a very good concept. And especially about, you mentioned this idea about a apex body to sort of nurture the peer support movement. Even that is an excellent idea, I think.
I agree with you. And, you know, training, a booklet or any training resource, if you can develop.
Exchange of ideas, thoughts, breakthroughs, anything that works for each, you know, it doesn't even have to be any. That is an excellent idea that we must take forward. I mean, it doesn't take much, right?
Because even it can be a fellowship. If any one of you want to take it up as a fellowship topic, that can be explored.
Exactly.
Initiate such a movement.
Yeah.
I think it just requires people coming together. Pooja. Sorry.
Please carry on. Can I add something? You know, मेरा यह हमेशा मानना है एज अ ट्रांसलेटर दैट मोस्ट ऑफ मेंटल हेल्थ डिस्कोर्स इन इंडिया इज ऑल्सो हैपनिंग ओनली इन इंग्लिश सो आई कम फ्रॉम शिमला आई ग्रू अप देयर इज ओनली वन स्मॉल साइकाइट्री डिपार्टमेंट इन द मेडिकल कॉलेज देयर द गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड आई नो अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट ऑफन द वैकेंसीज रिमेन अनफिल्ड एंड देयर आर नो डॉक्टर्स देयर एंड छोटे शहरों में इसलिए और भी जरूरी हो जाता है कि कुछ और तो हो साइकेट्रिस्ट नहीं है तो उनको दूसरे शहर जाके क्या ढूंढना है क्या टेस्ट करवाना है किससे मिलना है ये बताने वाला भी कोई नहीं है और अगर उनकी भाषा में नहीं हो रहा है सपोज इफ दे सी मी स्पीकिंग इन अ कॉन्फ्रेंस लाइक आई यूजुअली डू आई माइट साउंड वेरी इंटिमिडेटिंग टू देम इन माई इंग्लिश तो मेरे को उनकी भाषा में उनकी लोकल भाषा में उनकी लोकल मान्यताओं के हिसाब से उनके सोशियो इकोनॉमिक बैकग्राउंड के हिसाब से अगर मैं उनसे बात कर पाती हूँ तो मेरा सपोर्ट ग्रुप शायद सक्सेसफुल होगा मुझे ये इंग्लिश वाला इलिटिज्म मेंटल हेल्थ में बहुत बॉदर करता है इंडिया में इसको हिंदी तक और रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस तक जब तक हम नहीं लेके जाएंगे इट रिमेन्स एन इलिटिस्ट प्रिविलेज I am sorry to say that, but that is how I feel about it.
Bilkul, Pooja. Bilkul, that's a very valid point. I agree with you. And as long as we keep interacting only in English, we would not be able to reach grassroots or different sections.
Absolutely.
But,
Anil ji ka maine dekha hai, zyada the resources aapka Marathi mein rehta hai.
Yes.
Us community ke saath aap kaam kar rahe hai. Really, think that is a good step, you know, to publish resources in the language that you
actually
people. Hanji, Anil ji, aap kuch keh rahe hain?
Ye Priyavanda na?
Pooja, it was Pooja. Yeah,
Pooja. Sorry.
Pooja Priyavanda. Yeah.
बहुत valid point था और जैसे उन्होंने बोला कि अलग-अलग situations लोग होते हैं और उनके साथ उनका कल्चर भी अलग होता है इकोनॉमिक सोशल बैकग्राउंड भी अलग होती है तो उस तरीके से बात करने की बहुत जरूरी है वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है और ऐसा हो सकता है कि ये देखिए कि हमारा एक्सपीरियंस ऐसा है कि शुरू में ज़्यादा जो इंटेलेक्चुअल है जो वेल सेटल है वो लोग ज़्यादा आते हैं सपोर्ट ग्रुप में कहाँ भी ग्रुप की शुरुआत कर दीजिए जो लोग लाइफ में सेटल्ड है और जो कुछ इंटरैक्ट वो लोग शुरू में ज्यादा आते हैं एंड अदर पीपल टेक सम टाइम होता है तो आपका कहना सही है कि उस तरीके से ही बात करने की जरूरत है और मुझे लगता है कार्तिक और गौरी का भी जो क्वेश्चंस था तो अभी ये जो व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप और इंटरनेट का जो जमाना है इसमें सपोर्ट ग्रुप की ऑप्शन बढ़ गई है और हमें जितना छोटा चाहिए बड़ा चाहिए और जिस होमोजीनियस ग्रुप चाहिए उस तरीके से हम ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं तो क्योंकि पहले 20 साल पहले और जहां डायरेक्ट फेस टू फेस मीटिंग की जरूरत थी तो अभी व्हाट्सएप और इंटरनेट से हम at least some benefits we can derive. So मुझे लगता है कि the opportunities are much more and support group के लिए दो लोग होते हैं तो भी चलेगा. ऐसा कुछ ये नहीं है कि बहुत लोग ही चाहिए. तो दो लोग है, तीन लोग है, कुछ स्टैंड कुछ प्रोटोकॉल्स उनको हम पता कर सकते हैं. ये बुकलेट का पर्पस वही था कि जो फैसिलिटेटर है वो किस तरीके से बात करे, कौन सी चीज़ें बोलना चाहिए, कौन सी चीज़ें नहीं बोलना चाहिए, ऐसा कुछ उसमें गाइडलाइंस गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल्स लिखी थी. तो ऐसी कुछ चीज़ें हो सकती है. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जैसी आशा वर्कर हम कहते हैं उस तरीके से सपोर्ट ग्रुप के लिए भी ऐसे कुछ लोग हो सकते हैं कि दोज हु आर वॉलेंटरीली रेडी टू स्पीक विद अदर पीपल. और उसके लिए भी कुछ हम ऐसा कुछ तय कर सकते हैं क्योंकि बहुत सारे मीटिंग्स भी स्ट्रेसफुल हो सकती है. तो एटलीस्ट दो मीटिंग्स की सर्विस फ्री मिल सकती है, चार मीटिंग्स की सर्विस हो सकती है, ऐसा कुछ भी हो सकता है. तो ऐसा कुछ हो सकता है तो जब हम बात करते हैं तब उनको स्ट्रेस से बाहर आने का गाइडेंस स्ट्रेस से बाहर आने का बेनिफिट मिलेगा. और उसके अलावा ये मीटिंग्स के बाद वो खुद को कैसे सेल्फ हेल्प कर सकते हैं इसकी भी गाइडलाइंस कुछ उनको मिल सकती है. तो ये जो वर्ल्ड है सेल्फ हेल्प का जो विश्व है कि जो उनके लिए टोटली उनको पता नहीं है तो उसका इंट्रोडक्शन एटलीस्ट हम ये दो चार मीटिंग से करवा कर सकते हैं. या
Anil ji, in fact, initially we had this same issue that you are referring to, that it does not about the numbers. I remember the first meet which we only 1% agreed to attend the meet, and I went ahead and attended the meet. Two other people joined us subsequently for that meet. Second meet, just 1% came and met me, but I took a vow that every month I will go for the meet, irrespective of whether any participant comes or not. Since then the momentum gathered and then we never had to look back, you know. So if we wait, especially with the issue that I think Karthik raised, where, you know, in smaller towns or where there is resistance, we will have to display a lot of patience, which even in a city like Mumbai we had to face. Yeah. You know, so imagine the resistance in smaller towns, isn't it? Yeah.
Right, too.
And Gauriji had a question for me. Can I answer that?
Yeah, of course.
She had asked about that stigma and denial. Now, how this works, I agree a lot about how people can be in denial, and I referred to that initially also. That's why sometimes we keep the caregivers and the users together, because sometimes one person pulls the other to the meeting, you know, otherwise somebody else, sometimes the family members are in denial. We have such families also, where the parents are totally in denial that there is any mental illness, all right? And the other way around, where the person is in denial. So, just recently there is an incident where the mother of the person was there in our group, yeah? Son was in total denial, had a habit of addiction also, lives with bipolar disorder, alcoholism, substance abuse and all that also. Now he has joined our group, he has attended two meets, and there is a complete turnaround story. Yeah. So denial might be there at one stage, but we have to hold on to the hope that the things will change, you know, gradually. So a person who was in complete denial is now very compliant and, you know, disciplined and very enthusiastic about his own recovery, his rights and all those things. Yeah. And that is just one example. There have been many such examples of how a peer community can impact people's lives. Anil ji must have experienced many such cases, I'm sure, yeah, in all these years.
Any other?
I'd like to butt in here. Can you guys hear me?
Yes, welcome. Huh?
Yeah, so listening to what has been said till now, I just had this, this is something that will work or this might work. I personally, taking from my own personal experience, when I first went to a sort of general psychiatric unit in a hospital. First of all, it's very segregated and in a corner almost of the hospital. And you go there, the psychiatrist will give you only 5 minutes of his time. And for, we have to see for all the people, like for somebody who's just being introduced to his disease right now. So if somebody just tells me what you're dealing with is depression, and I don't know anything about depression, or if somebody tells me I'm dealing with psychosis and I don't know what it means, we can have, and we can try this model at a very small scale where, because the psychiatrist does not have time and you and your family members don't know what this depression thing is, we can have representatives of these small peer support groups or people who have, say, resources listing down that, okay, this is a self-help group on depression. This is a resource material that will give you a lot of information in your local language. That representative, his only work in the hospital, because you have to see first contact hospital, right? The first contact is either, I mean, if it's a rural area, it's traditional healers and we can't, I mean, udhar bhi kuch chal raha hai in terms of partnerships. But agar urban ya choti cities mein agar pehla contact aapka psychiatric unit hai and he's not giving you enough information that you need, because see, you can be somebody who is, for example, I have an electronic lighter in my house. I don't know how it works. I just know battery dalo to chalta hai. But if my life depends on knowing about this disease, even as a caregiver, I should know everything, accurate information about that disease, and somebody should give that to me. Agar meko doctor nahi de raha, psychiatrist nahi de raha, so we can have this, you know, a representative who will give you, sort of sit you down, aadhi ghante mein aapko bataye de ki aap peer support group aisa kaam karta hai, this is how it helps, and you know, this is the resource you can, iske baare mein par sakto, maybe you'll be better informed to make an informed decision about your recovery. So I feel as a small model, if you're trying to practice, what we can do is set up in a small remote area, just these representatives who, if, and people for different, you know, agar depression ke liye ek alag representative hai, for bipolar disorder, there's a different representative who will tell you, ki haan pe aap yahan ja ke help le sakte ho, agar aapko doctor nahi help kar raha, there's a peer support group here. For example, bipolar India for bipolar disorder, or aap Lucknow mein, aap Pune mein ho settle, to aapko bata sakte hai, aapko this is schizophrenia and this is what the disorder is, and you can go to SA and take help and, you know, learn about this. So this, I mean, I'm not saying lack of resources to hai, but there are already resources which people don't know about, and aapko wo information dena hai, like a directory sort of, ki haan pe aap ja sakte ho, is something I feel another area of intervention that we, as you know, people who are working in support groups and people with experience, can actually is samay is cheez pe kaam hum log definitely kar sakte hain.
Bilkul Pulak, that's an important area where service users and families members can bridge the gap, like information available.
Mona ji, if you are aware of Atmiyata Foundation, they are following a very similar model. Anil ji must be aware of it.
Yeah.
In Gujarat, and now they are expanding to Maharashtra as well. You know, affiliations with hospitals, having volunteers as part of the hospitals, all right, facilitating rehabilitation, which was just mentioned by Pulak, right? So they have that model in Gujarat, I think in Mehsana, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, if you have, you can, I'll share it in the group, Pulak. Yeah,
I think that would be very useful. Yes, yeah.
And another hindrance that might come in this, like if anyone trying to do this, is rightly pointed out by Vijay sir and Anilji also, is that the psychiatrist has to be readily, you know, or the mental health professional has to readily accept कि आप लोग भी आके इस चीज में हेल्प कर सकते हो, बिकॉज अगेन दैट प्रोफेशनल इनसिक्योरिटी एंड सुपीरियोरिटी विल ऑल कम इन एंड बी लाइक नहीं नहीं आप और अलग स्ट्रे कर दोगे एंड वी आर द एक्सपर्ट्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. आई थिंक अगर उधर से एक हाथ बढ़े तो यू नो इट विल बी एग्जीक्यूट करने में आसान होगा, और आई थिंक दैट या आई मीन दैट विल बी वन हिंड्रेंस दैट वी फेस इफ वी ट्राई टू समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो वी नीड एलाइज. हम लोग सिर्फ स्टार्टिंग में हम लोग ही नहीं कह सकते नहीं, वी डोंट. We need all allies that we can get in the beginning when it's a small movement. So, yeah.
True, true.
Yes. I just like to mention that for our peer support group, we actually never got in touch with a psychologist or a psychiatrist. A psychologist did once visit us to have a chat with us, but that was also because she was also a service user. not because she was attending it in the capacity of a psychologist. The reason why we stuck to that idea was because we didn't want to pathologize the experience any further than what it already is. We anyway understand our illnesses through a very strict medical lens, and the idea was to accept our environment and understand our environment better in order to understand triggers. So we did keep a distance from psychiatrists and psychologists, but we do, however, have a list of our own where we have tried and tested psychiatrists and psychologists who we suggest to people who may want that kind of help.
Yeah, another thing is, Hina, which that is what we are also following. Another reason is that sometimes people hesitate in when they know there is a professional amidst the group, you know, in the meet, you know. Have you experienced that? I mean, that sense of something.
There is somehow then, you know, the whole thing comes up that you know about my situation better than I do myself, which is what we want to at all points avoid, because we want people to know that their experience is valid and is what makes their condition difficult or not difficult for them.
And here what happens, they can criticize psychiatrists, other practitioners, therapists, because they know that only our community is, you know, a homogeneous community is engaging with each other, you know, practitioners, right?
Yeah.
I think what Pulak perhaps was saying, Pulak, did you say that psychiatric community should accept Pulak?
Yes,
आप ऐसे बोल रहे थे क्या psychiatrist community should accept
yes sir, but मेरा ये भी ये मतलब ये भी जानता हूँ मैं कि ये हमारे हाथ में है नहीं, you know, I can only hope कि वहाँ से एक you know they reach out a hand to sort of pull us into the mainstream and you know like an alternate model of recovery, लेकिन लेकिन उनकी training, I mean it goes back to their training, right? उनका training में they've been इतना strictly taught the medical model only. I mean, they're not taught about, जैसे हम लोगों को social work में सिखाते हैं community mental health के बारे में और deinstitutionalization के बारे में. I don't think in their training they're ever taught कि you know this is what traditional healers are doing or this is what Ayurveda is doing and maybe you can also you know refer people to. I don't think it's a problem of training. तो वो जब उस school से बाहर आते हैं, तो I don't think they will readily accept anyone and they'll be like, नहीं नहीं, I don't think this is good.
मेरा एक्सपीरियंस ऐसा है कि कई सालों का जो एक्सपीरियंस है कि साइकेट्रिस्ट विल नॉट एक्सेप्ट विल नॉट एनकरेज अवर एग्जिस्टेंस ऑन देयर ओन. वी हैव टू पुश अवर वे एंड कंफ्लिक्ट एंड कोलैबोरेशन दीज आर द दिस कुड बी द स्ट्रेटजी. वी कैन नॉट आउटराइट से दैट दे आर नॉट हेल्पफुल बिकॉज सम साइकेट्रिस्ट आर डेफिनेटली हेल्पफुल नो डाउट. But they may not have any, may not be heard in the organizations. They may be outsiders or maybe at the margin. So I think that we have to push our way, because if we expect that sometime they will listen to or see our existence, importance, stage of time, we must learn to push our way on our own, but at the same time collaborate also whenever they are ready.
Anilji, now what's happening is there are people, professionals who want to collaborate with us, but now we are a bit cautious about whom to join hands with, whether there is a vested interest in there, you know.
No, they cannot. If you they are ready, it is better to join with the body, professional body. I suppose Mumbai Psychiatric Association is a very strong body, so it is better to join with them. So that
we have an indirect connection, Anilji, because Dr. Milan is on the part of the BBS, and he's on the committee as well. You know who is our panelist psychiatrist? Okay, Dr. Milan Balakrishnan.
Okay.
Who is at Messina Hospital and Bombay Hospital. So he's on Bombay with Bombay Psychiatric Society and on their committee as well. Okay.
I just want to give another case study and sort of to apna point aur acche se rakhne ke liye. There's this NGO Anjali in Kolkata, and they started out. Most of the NGOs earlier they say that the state is not doing anything, but we are going to do our own thing. NGO Anjali ka ye tha ki unhone kaha ki India is a welfare state aur mental health jo hai wo bhi India as a hum logo ka government ka responsibility hai. So what they started doing was also they did a very interesting thing, which was जब इस जगह के 80% लोग का पहला कॉन्टैक्ट और वो जा रहे हैं सिर्फ जनरल मतलब आपका जनरल मेंटल हॉस्पिटल्स में, तो आई थिंक दैट्स द बेस्ट प्लेस टू गेट इन पीपल और इवन हेल्प इन वॉट एवर वे यू कैन. सो दे डिड पार्टनरशिप्स विद द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट उनको आफ्टर दे सॉ दैट द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दे वर डूइंग उनको हॉस्पिटल्स में उन्होंने इंक्लूड किया. Or, you know, people who recovered from that NGO, people who recovered from that NGO, they started working in the hospitals as staff members and in hotels. And also, Ratnabali Ray is also working in at the policy level at the state. So she was included in the Abhi the Mental Health Review Board. Nahi hai, even before that, she was a part of the change in policies. So I feel... आपको यू हैव टू बी अ लिटिल कनिंग एंड सी कि सबसे ज्यादा लोग जो पीपल यू वांट टू वर्क विद इफ दे आर गोइंग टू दिस वन प्लेस एंड यू डोंट अग्री विद देम योर यू हैव टू फर्स्ट कीप दैट असाइड एंड सी एटलीस्ट वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस आवरसेल्व्स देयर एंड इफ दे आर विलिंग एंड वेलकमिंग देन इट कैन सॉर्ट ऑफ डेवलप इनटू अ ब्यूटीफुल सॉर्ट ऑफ पार्टनरशिप एंड वो. तो आई जस्ट वांटेड टू गिव दिस एग्जांपल एंड आई फील काफी रेलेवेंट है.
ओके थैंक यू Anil ji, yes. Kuch kehne. Any other comment or anybody else wants to say something in response to what Pulak and Anil ji just discussed? I think we are at a stage where we should not think of excluding people, but we should be inclusive. What I do is that if I find people who are sensitive, whose ideas resonate with our organization, we engage them, whether they are professionals, mental health professionals, not mental health professionals, psychiatrists or so. But we keep our engagement on. And of course, not all psychiatrists and psychologists would not like peer support groups. I know some psychiatrists who promote and where they have created groups of their patients and they encourage their patients to interact with each other. So is it time to end this group?